All right, today's Thursday, July 23rd, 2009, and this is your Daily Dose. I'm going to start with a couple of quotes today that are going to take us into what I want to talk about. And they're from John Maxwell's 21 Indispensable Qualities of a Leader, and here's the first quote. Success seems to be connected with action. Successful people keep moving. They make mistakes, but they don't quit. And that was by Conrad Hilton, hotel executive. And then the next quote is, of all the things a leader should fear, complacency should head the list. I'm going to start trying to start every day with a little bit of a couple of quotes for you guys to get your days going. And it leads me to what I want to talk about. There's doers and there's talkers. The doers are too busy doing to listen to what the talkers are talking about. And the talkers are too busy talking about what the doers are doing that they don't ever actually do anything except talk. Well, I'm a doer. For example, told people, you know, a couple years ago that I would have an office, that I would be doing, and all the people around me look and see now that, wow, he wasn't playing. He has an office. He's getting ready to launch the college, all the stuff that he said. He has billboard. He has a cool big computer in his office, just like he said. He's got clients. I mean, the point being is there was a plan. I said I was going to do all these things. I don't let anything get in the way. Talk doesn't stop me. I listen to what other people are saying, absorb it. But in the grand scheme of things, if I just stop for a second and realize that it doesn't affect anything that I'm doing when people are talking, it's what's allowed me to get to where I'm at right now, to have this office, to be at the point where we're working towards the Clark County Cannabis College. We're getting all the paper, everything we need done. It's gotten me to the point where now I, at one point where I was praying and hoping to find work, now people contact me praying and hoping that I can hire them. It's very humbling. I'm very grateful for that, to have put myself in that position. But what I've come to realize is I got to this position because I started doing. Action and motion, like, were the two greatest allies that I could have. I started acting on everything that I had said I was going to do. It didn't take money. It just took me, if I didn't have money, then I needed to go talk to somebody who did, that might like my idea and help me. Point is I did it. Where I could sit at home all day. I want to use an example because when I first started to do this, I was trying to find I was trying to hire web designers to help me design my site, which I eventually ended up going to a semester of CSN, learning the stuff myself and producing my own site. Because what I found is people just don't understand the value of work this day and age. They tell you what they can do, and then they say, well, I don't work for free. You're going to have to pay me. Well, the point is this. If you're looking for work like that, here's one thing that I learned. It's called work ethic. And it's, if I'm at home and I'm not doing anything that's bettering myself, and I was a web designer, this is what I would do. I would look at the site, and when I saw a site, and I'd be thinking to myself, man, that site's kind of doo-doo. I could probably design something better. What I would do is I would design just a template. Just a simple JPEG, not the whole functionality of a website, just what you see. In other words, when you load up Yahoo, what Yahoo looks like. I would design something, and I would go into that business, and I would say, hey, you know, I've been looking at your website for a long time, and it's just not as appealing as it potentially could be. Here's what I did. I whipped up this cool little picture. It's just a JPEG, has no functionality, but this is what your site could look like. Now, I can make all the other buttons and stuff that you see in this picture work correctly, but my time is valuable just as yours is. So my time is valued at this amount. If it's worth it, if it's worth it to me and you've shown me good work, then I'm going to lay out the cheese. That's just the way it is. I told a t-shirt guy, hey, I need t-shirts. I need them real fast. I need him to say get legal with an open cross and a purple leaf in them with get MCCMB. Well, what do you know? $1,000 check later, boom, I got t-shirts. There's doers and there's talkers. Now, what did he do? As soon as I told him I need t-shirts, he didn't say, hey, I need some money to make you a sample. Bam, he pressed one off. Next thing you know, I get a text message. Bam, this is what I got right now. That's called doing work. He didn't just tell me, oh, but I got this t-shirt machine in my garage. I make cool t-shirts for people. No, he made a t-shirt and he said, James, I got these t-shirts I can make for you. This is how much I need to make them though. Maybe it's worth it to you, but always know this, this t-shirt's available for me to make for you. Now you see Get Legal t-shirts flying out the door, people getting their cards, getting legal. Word of mouth advertising. I got advertisers calling me. Everybody, it's such a hard economy. People are trying to advance and progress. I honestly can't afford it. I budgeted everything that I had to be able to do what I'm doing to help patients. Now I'm going to hire eventually because I'm going to have the money because I know I'm going to because I'm doing what I need to do now to make that happen. But the main thing is keep the essays coming. Don't worry, I will respond. When the time comes, you will all get a response, I promise. Some of you, I would encourage you from this point forward, maybe you might want to resubmit something a little bit more thought out with spell check, things like that, because this, even though it's not a formal application, it is a reflection of you and what you bring to the table. And I'll be quite truthful, some of what I've received, I would not want to be the last reflection that somebody had of me. Now, I have a contest going. Once again, I'm focusing at graphic designers. What I'm doing is this. We're trying to come up with a new logo for the Clark County Cannabis College. What I am looking for is JPEGs, PSD, Photoshop, whatever. Or you can print it out and come show me in person with your name and information on it. Don't worry, it's yours. I'm not going to steal it from you. You're not going to lose copyright. There's no contract or anything like that. Anybody who does work for me, it's their work. They will get credit for it, always. So I'm having a contest. Now, if you have a qualifying medical condition, maybe there's a trade involved. If you have a t-shirt company and you have a qualifying medical condition, maybe trades can be involved. I say that because there's always a way. People say, well, I don't have money. There's always a way. I didn't have money for an attorney, but I'll tell you what, when I told him, hey, whatever it takes, I'll come down here on Saturdays and Sundays. You save money on your landscaping bill. I'll do all that for you. I'll clean and wash your windows. Take all the money that you save, apply it towards my legal defense. Whatever it takes. Because when I tell people and I give them my word that that's what I'm going to do, that's what's going to happen. There's doers and there's talkers. Start doing. Stop talking. This was July 23rd, 2009, and this was your Daily Dose.